Good morning everyone. Today we'll discuss on lateral earth pressure. So what is meant by lateral earth pressure? This is a pressure that soil exerts in the horizontal direction. Means pressure to the side or sideways pressure. This lateral pressure is important because it affects the consolidation behavior and strength of the soil. And this is the natural ground level. There are three categories of earth pressure: earth pressure at rest, active earth pressure, and passive earth pressure. What do you mean by earth pressure at rest? Means the lateral pressure caused by earth, which is prevented from lateral movement by unyielding way. Active earth pressure means, the name itself says that it's active, which occurs when a retained soil mass is allowed to relax or deform laterally and outward to the point of mobilizing its available full shear resistance. Means this is the pressure which is occur when soil is retained, when the soil mass is retained, which is allowed to get relaxed. Passive earth pressure, this is a state occurs when a soil mass is externally forced laterally and inward towards the soil mass. If you see difference between active earth pressure and passive earth pressure, the active earth pressure laterally and outward, this is laterally and inward towards the soil mass. Now we'll see an example problem. For the retaining wall, which is shown in the figure, determine the lateral earth force at rest. As we have seen, there are three categories: earth pressure at rest, active and passive. This is an example problem for earth force at rest, and determine the location of the resultant force. So this is the given figure in which two types of soils and unit weight of soils are given, angle is given, and this is the groundwater table which is acting from 2.5 meters from the base. To do this solution, to go to the problem, we have some equations where k naught is equal to 1 minus sine pi. Pi angle is given 30 degrees. Substitute the angle in the given formula. 1 minus sine pi gives you 1 minus sin 30 gives you 0.5. At z, this is the z. At z is equal to 0, sigma stresses is equal to 0. If it says z is equal to 2.5, stress is equal to 16.5 into 2.5. This unit weight of this soil is 16.5 into the height is 2.5, gives you 41.25 kilometer per meter square. Now, stress is equal to 0.5 into the total stress. 0.5 into 41.25 gives you 20.63. And if z is equal to 5 meters, just now we have seen if z is equal to 2.5. If z is equal to 5 meters, then this unit weight in multiplied with this and this unit weight multiplied with this. We will see here 16.25 into 2.5 plus 19.3, this is 19.3 into 2.5, 19.3, and this is in the under the water table. This is a groundwater table. So this is the saturated. So deduct the unit weight of water, that is 9.81. So 19.3 is a unit weight of soil given minus 9.81. Then you will be getting the unit weight of dry soil given multiplied with 2.5. 2.5 means is the height of this soil, which gives you 64.98. And then this is multiplied with 0.5, which gives you 32.49. Now you got two values. To draw this distribution curve, soil distribution diagram, so this is a 20.63. you have to write the value, and this is the 32.49. You have to write the value here. So now when you draw this soil distribution diagram, profile diagram, so you can categorize into, you can divide this section into three types. You can divide it into three sections. This one is the triangle, second one is rectangle, and third one is triangle. And in continuation to this, you have to calculate hydrostatic pressure distribution. Z is equal to 0 to Z is equal to 2.5. U is equal to 0, pore pressure. At Z is equal to 5, U is equal to 9.81. This is the height. And the unit weight of water is 9.81. 9.81 into this height gives you 24.53. So you have to draw a profile distribution diagram for this 24.53. So we have to consider now three sections. One is triangle, second is rectangle, and third one is triangle. If you see, the total unit weight, total force per unit length of the wall can be determined. So there are three sections for the soil profile distribution. These are the three sections, and this is the section for hydrostatic pressure. So there are four sections, so we'll get four areas. So what is the, if you see the first section, it is a triangle. So what is the formula to calculate area of triangle? It is half BH, and area of rectangle L into B. Again, this is triangle, half BH, and this is a triangle, half BH. If you see, 1 by 2, half BH plus L into B plus half BH plus half BH gives you the total force. Next, in the question, he asked to determine the location of the resultant force. So to calculate the resultant center of pressure or resultant, what is the formula we have? We have to consider in y direction. So he is asking to calculate the location of resultant force. So from here to 0 to 5, in some place the force is acting. The location of resultant force acts. So what is the height of that? So what is the formula we have? A1 y1 plus A2 y2 plus A3 y3 plus A4 y4. So area we already know here. So just substitute the values here, and y1, again the y1, y2, y3, y4 depends upon the structure sections. So the first section is triangle. If you see this section, here to here is the height is, we have to consider center of gravity for each section. So the CP lies exactly in center in each section. So for the first section, it lies in the center, second section lies in the center, third section lies in the center, and fourth section lies in the center. So how to calculate this CP for the first section? We have to take from the base, consider from the base. So the center of gravity or CP lies in the center, that means here. So what is the height from base? So here to here is 2.5, and this is a triangle, so it is h by 3. 2.5 plus h by 3. What is this h? 2.5. So 2.5 plus this 2.5 divided by 3. 2.5 plus 2.5 divided by 3 plus area of second rectangle. That is area of second section called, that is nothing but rectangle. And what is, how to determine center of gravity or CP for this section? It lies in the center. So this is total is h by 2. So h by 2 gives you y2. What is h? 2.5. 2.5 divided by 2. And similarly for third and fourth, substitute all the values in the formulas and you will be getting 1.53 meters. So the formula is a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 plus a4 y4 divided by total area. Total area. If you see the total area, this is the total, or nothing but we can say load, and you will be getting 1.53 meters. Now, from the figure, we can see from the base 1.53 meters, there is the location of resultant force. So this is how to calculate or determine the location of the resultant force and how to determine lateral earth force at rest. Hope this gives you a bit understanding on this topic. Thank you.